The drawing piano class used in this video can be downloaded from java.martincarlisle.com. We're now going to look at creating a simple animation. In the class Bouncing Ball, we will draw a yellow ball on the screen, starting in a random location and moving in a random direction. When the ball reaches an edge of the window, it will bounce off the edge elastically and continue moving. We start by creating a point object that will keep track of the location of the ball, and randomizer, an object of the class random, that we will use to create random numbers. We also declare dx and dy to represent the speed of the ball in the x and y direction. The last variable we'll declare is panel, a drawing panel. Note that we are using a constant window size to make it easy to change the size of the window. Calling the nextInt method on the randomizer object will give us a number from 0 to window size minus ball radius minus 1. We then add ball radius. This should guarantee that the starting position of the ball is on the screen. We set the initial location of the ball using two such random numbers. We then provide an initial speed in the x and y direction. Since nextInt might return 0, we add 1 to each of these to guarantee they are positive. We then have a loop that will continue until the left mouse button is clicked. In each iteration of the loop, we clear the off-screen graphics, draw the ball, and then copy the off-screen graphics to the screen. This use of double buffering, rather than drawing directly on the visible screen, reduces flicker in the animation. After that, we call a method to move the ball and wait 100 milliseconds before repeating. Now let's look at the method for drawing the ball. It takes in the graphics object and location of the ball, sets the color, and then draws a circle centered at the ball location. Drawing a circle is accomplished by specifying the upper left corner and width and height of a box in which an oval is inscribed. The method moveBall does the work of updating the ball's location. A point object in Java has two attributes, x and y. We simply add dx and dy to these. If the ball is about to go off the screen horizontally, that is, if x is less than the radius, or within the radius of the right edge, we simply reverse the direction of horizontal motion by negating dx. We do the same with dy. We'll now run the program. As expected, the ball is moving across the screen. But wait, it didn't bounce at the edge. To figure out why, we'll run the debugger to check and see if dx and dy are being updated. We place a couple breakpoints where those values should be updated and run the debugger. As we see, dx is being negated. We'll continue stepping through the program. Once we get back to main, dx has become positive again. This highlights a common mistake with Java parameters. When you modify a parameter, you're only changing a copy. The original is unchanged. We fixed this problem in the class Bouncing Ball Fixed. Here, instead of passing dx and dy to move ball, we pass a point. We are then able to change the value of the point's coordinates inside the method, and those changes will not be lost when we return to main. You might wonder why passing an object works when passing ints did not. Aren't we passing a copy in both cases? It's true that we are passing a copy in both cases, but you might picture a bank account with an ATM card. If I make a copy of an ATM card and give it to you, and you change the number on it, my ATM card and bank balance aren't changed. But if I give you a copy of my ATM card, and you use that copy to withdraw money, I will also see the change in my account balance. When you pass a number, you are merely making a copy and can't change the original. When you pass an object, though, you are passing a copy of a reference which can be used to modify the underlying object. In our example, my bank account. But in this case, the underlying point which has the ball's velocity. Now we'll run the fixed program. You can see that the ball does indeed bounce when it reaches an edge.